How does Kaleidoscope handle zero-crossing files? A zero-crossing file is a specific format which is typically used to record bat calls. Unlike a full-spectrum file, a zero-crossing file does not contain any amplitude information and can only represent a single frequency over time. Kaleidoscope can open and process zero-crossing files. Kaleidoscope can convert full-spectrum audio files into zero-crossing files. Let's take a look at how that works. To convert WAV files to zero-crossing format, select the input and output directories. Make sure WAV files are checked for input. Check the output option to create zero-crossing files. Press the Process Files button. The selected WAV files have now been recreated as zero-crossing files. Here is a zero-crossing view of a bat call. Some ultrasonic recorders only create zero-crossing files, so if this file had been created by a native zero-crossing recorder, this is what would have been captured. You can see the beginning of the zero-crossing recording does look like a bat call, but towards the end of the call, the zero-crossing dots appear to jump all over the place. What is going on here? It just so happens this recording was originally made as a full-spectrum recording. And if we look at the full-spectrum recording, we see harmonics and at least one, if not two, other bats. The zero-crossing view we just saw was a conversion done by Kaleidoscope from full-spectrum to zero-crossing. If Kaleidoscope works the same way as a native zero-crossing recorder, this is the kind of mess that can happen. But Kaleidoscope has a secret. Well, it's not a secret, but it is a very powerful feature. Under the Signal Params tab is a checkbox which is labeled When Zero Crossing for Conversion or Analysis, Enhance with Advanced Signal Processing. This box is checked by default, but of course you can disable the function if you like. The advanced signal processing is used specifically when full spectrum files are converted into zero crossing format. If Kaleidoscope opens a native zero crossing file, this signal processing does not apply. The first thing the processing does is decrease the background noise. This enables Kaleidoscope to pick out much fainter signals than a native zero crossing recorder would be able to detect. Kaleidoscope looks at the overall shape of the call and then recognizes the chaos at the end of the call caused by the other bats is not part of the original call. So the original call is isolated and then converted to zero crossing. This provides a much higher quality zero crossing representation of the bat call. Kaleidoscope Pro can run an auto-ID process on both zero-crossing and full-spectrum files. Zero-crossing is an integral part of the auto-ID function. When full-spectrum files are used for auto-ID inputs, Kaleidoscope Pro can apply the enhanced signal processing to get the best possible zero-crossing representations and therefore the best auto-ID results. Thank you for watching.